Hello and welcome back. Have you been in your Cisco Webex meeting recently with a polar bear or a fox or Father Christmas or Donald Trump? Maybe you have. In that case then, the people you've been having a meeting with is using a piece of software called Facerig. We're going to go through where you can get Facerig, what it is, how you configure it, and how you configure it with Cisco Webex. Let's talk about Facerig. So heading on over to Facerig, a quick Google will bring up the Steam page and also the web page, facerig.com. And as you can see from the facerig.com page, there's an awful lot of people having much fun and much hilarity as they change their faces to that of a fox or a lady or a dragon or a beef burger or Father Christmas or Donald Trump, things like that. As I said, it is available on Steam. Click on the shop on Steam, will take you to the Steam page, and you can see the price list at the moment. Now, buy Facerig, $12.99. If you're also a fan of Humble Bundle, sometimes they run some deals as well with the Facerig software. That's where I got mine from, at a bit of a reduced price. There is some DLC as well that you can get hold of, and this DLC does bring even more fun into the genea. So, using this with a tool like Webex, and indeed in with Webex Teams, you know, Cisco Webex and Cisco Webex Teams, couldn't be easier. Download the software first. Once you've got it downloaded, we can go through the setup and then get it integrated into Webex. Now here I am in my very busy workshop and office area that I tend to spend an awful lot of my time in. Some of this might not be conducive to what you want to be doing, especially with some video conferencing. As this stands, however, a lot of people are working from home these days, people are learning from home, people aren't generally going into the offices, and everyone's spending their time collaborating on these tools like Google Meet, Microsoft Teams, etc., 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 and Cisco Webex and Webex Teams. So how can you put a little bit of fun in? Well, we can all change our background, and Cisco Webex can do that as well. There's a number of backgrounds that you can choose from, which is great. However, it can be a bit boring, and some work better than others. This, I think, is quite a good background to do, and all the other tools as well are offering the facility to change your backgrounds. Teams, Google has got it in its pipeline, and also Zoom. However, right, what if you want to go a step further than this? And have a different character and get rid of your face. So we're going to use Facerig, as I mentioned. So with that then, what do we do? Well, first off, we look at the Facerig software. So as I mentioned, Facerig has a lot of avatars that we can go through. And we're going to go through the setup and how to get this working with your video conferencing tool of choice, in this case, Cisco Webex. So this is the Facerig tool. At the top, you can see the basic interface. Now, this is very important. Switch the advanced interface. You saw it there, UI plus. Click on that, you get more facilities. Facilities to record your performance. Play the performance back. Lip sync. Do a quick auto calibration of expressions by clicking this, remaining with a passive expression and clicking calibrate. Reset your expressions. Also head pose. Click on this, look at the camera, click calibrate, that resets the head position of your avatar. How is this technology working? Is anything funky going on? Well, a good idea of this is showing the picture in picture. Now, I'm using my Microsoft LifeCam, but I haven't got these dots all over my face. The software is doing that, and that's how it's tracking my mouth, my eyes, and my eyebrows. You got that? Bit of eyebrow movement, close my eyes, smile, open my mouth, and I can move my head from side to side like this, whatever. If I look down, you can't see my face, you can see the dots disappear. So that's how it's doing it. And you can select your feed here as well from a list of different feeds that you can have on your machine. So that's how Facerig is doing it, and it's probably good to make sure you check on their website for the cameras that are actually compatible as well. Now I'm running this on an i7-3200. So it's quite an old processor, about 4 or 5 years old. It was top of the range when I bought it, but now it's getting degraded. Ninth gen are out and the i9s are out. My graphics card's a 1070 GTX, but I know it does work on 1050. So, but always worthwhile looking at the specs before you try it out. But Steam has got quite a good refund policy as well. So that's how the software is doing it. Great. So what do we need to get this feed into Webex, Cisco Webex? Well, the most important button for this is this toggle broadcast at the top. This will send what is on the screen with Facerig to your video feed. Now, as you can see, Cisco Webex, I haven't got a video feed there at the moment, and we'll put that just over there. So I'm going to click on broadcast at the top there. And that's now broadcasting to my video feed into Cisco Webex. I'm going to select my feed, my Facerig virtual camera. Very important to select your feed. And then start video. We'll change the background and take the background off. Some reason, Cisco Webex doesn't handle the background. You can just see it trying to break through a little bit. There you are. Click on then. Use the backgrounds that are coming through with Facerig, and you can see the polar bear. And then you can also do all the other stuff like connect to a video system as well, if you've got any of them knocking around where you can cast it to your video system. You can also, let's have a look now, turn your video off, then start the meeting. So, you know, it is quite robust. This is going from here to Cisco and out. So it works. So that's good stuff, no? I think it's good stuff. Let's just pop the meeting on end there. And what we'll do, we'll go back into the foyer section of things. Right, so I haven't started the meeting yet. I know exactly what my feed is. So say you're not too fussed about polar bears. Well, as I mentioned, Facerig has a number of avatars that come free with it. Not only do they come free, there are also some DLC on Steam that you can download that are also free. Some, however, you've got to pay for, but those aren't that expensive. To select your avatar, click on the avatar on the right-hand side. And you can see a long list of avatars and customization props that you can add on as well. Whether that be, you know, adding in some props here, you got flying helmets, lights, load avatar options, save avatar options. There's a number of things you can do. What behavior you want. You can customize this to your heart's content. But let's face it, you got a lot here. Look, a hell of a lot here. All the DLC that I've got. Bit of Donald Trump, which is a really good likeness, I think, to be honest. Bit of Hillary. Well, it looks like Hillary, if you ask me. And then you got the polar bear. You can change his shirt. Let's have a look for props. Add a prop. Can we put something in like, I don't know, glasses, attach. And then you can then move those and scale them, free move those glasses around should you want to put a hat on. And there's my polar bear wearing a witch's hat. There's the glasses, and again you can free move these glasses around should you want to. Put them on scale, put them on his face, reset all. There's some glasses up there. So let's get rid of that. Hat was quite good though, wasn't it? Attached to the head and then move it around when you can. Anyway, you can put on props if you want to and the behavior like I mentioned. But back to the avatar gallery, there are some classics here. There really are some classics. And by scrolling up and down, you can pick some quite scary ones. perhaps not for children, or things from Team Fortress, you know, which are quite nicely animated. You know, I do like these as well, and something special, especially for Halloween. So that was changing the avatar over. Couldn't be easier. And like I mentioned, if you go onto the web and look for the DLC on Steam, you can see there's a load of DLC you can do. And they give you some good examples as well. I mean, I quite like the Halloween ones. You can be PewDiePie for free if you want to. Octodad, things from Starbound. A lot of free, some you've got to pay for, but they're only like £3.99, British pounds, $5, something like that. So it's not too much of a stretch. Pretty good. For example, you know, if you're a teacher and you're teaching near Halloween, or if you're, example, you're teaching about Thanksgiving, do it as a turkey. Let's just get our tracking on the go here. The turkey is off the other side of the screen. And you've also got, you know, the Velociraptor as well. Look. From a teach us dinosaurs. Lots in there, lots of things you can do, but even just joining some meetings as well in school. What a piece of software to impress your friends with and irritate your teachers. And if you're in work, check your social collaboration policy, whether you can install anything on your work PC, but could inject a little bit of humor into those non-important team meetings as well. Or just use it with family and friends. So, I think that looks like Colonel Sanders, if you ask me. But there you are. Anyway, not to worry. Let's go for one of my favourites. It's the frog. There you go. I've got a frog there. Look, smoking a bubbled pipe. You know, it's great. So that's changing the avatar. What about other options? Well, you've got other options, like I mentioned, to record your performance. So you can put it into your video software of choice, not just Cisco Webex or Zoom or Teams or Google Meet. You can also change your environment. So you can put a pure green screen on, which is quite good. Or you can select from all these pre-loaded ones. Or you can add your own, which is also very good as well. Here, look, see, my frog is now in a very sort of cartoony backdrop. And then when we go into Cisco, you can see that's changed. And that's what people will be seeing in the meeting. And it's tracking my mouth. And everything. Lots of other options as well you can do. You can check your advanced tracking configuration. Let's look at that. You know how much CPU time it's using. You can really get into the resolutions of this. Even up the resolution there, the 720. That's also obviously going to increase your bandwidth usage that you use. So be very mindful of this. Also, you've got a karaoke panel, put some songs in there, sing along to the songs, and then obviously record your performance. Or you can put voice effects, like adding a voice effect echo or what have you onto this. Echoes and other ones as well, you can add additional effects. Let's get rid of those. Okay. Add text and an image overlay. So you can add an image. Let's look at the pictures folder. Put a bit of collaboration kernel on it. And I can place that image as a sort of a watermark, and I can change the size of this as well. And again, all that is transferable into Cisco Webex as well once you start using the overlay. And things start getting back to normal. Some of the alterations you may have to do a toggle with the broadcast to get things to translate through. If anything does freeze, always stop the video and then start the video, all depending on what you're doing with the webcam. If anything like this ever does happen and you start to lose your feed, toggle the broadcast off, shut down the Facerig, restart it, everything will start up fine. So thanks very much for watching. That was how to get Facerig working with Cisco Webex, and indeed then Cisco Webex Teams. I've got videos on how to get it working on Zoom, Microsoft Teams and Google Meet, and a couple of other varieties as well, perhaps using Snapcam. Thanks very much for watching. See you soon.